Ahoy mates, it's the Curse Captain Hippo TC here with a guide video to help you take on the new Ashen Lords in the latest update for Sea of Thieves called the Ashen Winds. So grab yourself a grog, hit that subscribe button if you have not yet subscribed, and let's jump into the video. The Ashen Lords are here and boy oh boy are we in for a fight. Flameheart has amassed all of the elements he needs to raise up his most loyal of followers and send them into the Sea of Thieves. This encounter is no simple encounter and will require you to keep your wits when fighting them. First, let's talk about where to find them. If you want to challenge these Ashen Lords, look to the skies and keep an eye out for the ominous twisting tornado on the horizon. Once spotted, load up your ship and supplies and set sail. It's my recommendation to stock up on as much food as possible because trust me on this one, you are going to need it. When approaching the island with a tornado, there's a couple of things you want to keep in mind. First, you don't want to park your ship so close, otherwise it could get hit with the falling fiery rocks. But you don't want to park it too far away, making it difficult to get back to just in case other pirates decide to come and quote, help you. So find a good spot, park your ship, and get ready to fight. All throughout this encounter, you will want to make sure your ship is safe and keep an eye on the horizon for other pirates. Now let's talk about fighting these Ashen Lords and the types of attacks they have. The first thing to keep in mind is that these Ashen Lords have no puny weapons and instead have quite a few attacks they can use. First, they will hurl fire rocks at players who dare to disrupt them. These rocks can be devastating and make quick work of you and your crew, so it's a good idea to take cover or run away from the area. If it wasn't enough, they also have what Rare is calling the Ashen Cursed Arm that they can use to throw pirates backwards, and if you think keeping a distance will keep you safe, think again, because these Ashen Lords are pretty quick on their feet and can swiftly lunge towards their targets. And if hurling rocks and cursed attacks weren't enough, these Ashen Lords can breathe in fire, setting players ablaze before plunging the world into darkness by releasing an eerie ash cloud from the spores on its back. If you manage to survive to the final stage of the encounter, get ready to experience what Rare is calling the Wrath of World's End. A volcanic rocks fall from above, geysers blast from the earth, and fire, yes, fire, curls around you. Now that you know what you're up against, let's talk about how to defeat them. Like I mentioned earlier, you're going to want to make sure you get as much food as possible to help stack the odds in your favor. Also, at any given moment during the encounter, grab yourself a bucket of water so that you can put yourself out just in case you get caught on fire. You can use any weapon combination of your choosing, but something I would recommend is grabbing yourself one of those beautiful portable ammo crates to help you and your crew stay stocked up and reload faster. And another good idea is to find yourself a storage crate and stock it up with all the food so that you don't have to run all the way back to your ship. You will want these resources close, but not too close. Attacking the Ashen Lords is straightforward enough. You can shoot them or hit them with your sword, but as you and your crew attack them and the Ashen Lords' health depletes, the Ashen Lords will begin to become frustrated and use more powerful attacks to repel the threat. That is when crews taking on the Ashen Lord will find out if they are true pirate legends or wee little swabbies. If you decide not to give up and take the battle to its bitter end, the Ashen Lords will get angrier, and when I say angrier, I mean they get angry and will start to use their more powerful abilities. So keep your wits about you and you will be just fine. Eventually, you will defeat the Ashen Lord. Geysers will erupt all around them, unearthing treasure for all who brave the encounter, in addition to their devastating skull. A skull, mind you, that pirates can turn into the Order of Souls, or it can be used as a deadly weapon. You can wield the Ashen Wind skull against rival players like a freaking flamethrower, causing nearby players, skeletons, and even ships to be set on fire. The ashen crystals inside the skull contain its cursed power and will eventually drain the more that you use it. So you want to keep that in mind, that they are worthless to the Order of Souls if their power is depleted. So if you do decide to use them, be responsible. Last thing I want to cover regarding the Ashen Lord is there are new commendations and achievements that have been added to the Sea of Thieves. These commendations will help you track your progression against the Ashen Menace, and the new Xbox and Steam achievements can be unlocked by progressing through these commendations. A total of 40 gamerscore is available to earn from this update, and these achievements will remain in the game indefinitely. So for all you achievement hunters, you are going to love that. There you have it, mates. This encounter is going to test your mettle and wits as pirates. Not only do you have to bring down a fiery Ashen Lord, but you will also have to keep your eyes on the horizon against other thieving pirates like myself. What are you most excited for, and what do you plan to do first with the new Ashen Wind skull that breathes fire? Let me know in the comments below, and I will see you out on the seas.